Hey, hello everyone, and welcome to the good news. My name is Pastor Rick, and this is my wife.
I'm Cheryl.
Hey, you know, we are filming this right now on, what is this? This is Friday afternoon.
Yes.
And normally filming on Thursday night.
Yes.
You know, I'm going to do music in a second here, but we could not film last night. Tell them what happened.
Well, we had a very severe thunderstorm. In fact, it blew out the whole building, and we think that even lightning hit the major generator that runs this entire building. So for about an hour and a half, this entire building was without power. We had a couple trapped in one of our elevators.
This older couple in the elevator.
Yes, but they were so cute.
Yes, Frank and Arlene, they're friends of ours, and they were like, we were talking, they're stuck between floors, and we're like, are you guys okay? And they said, don't hurry, we're smooching. I thought it was funny because they're just a very elderly couple.
And
it was cute. But so we're doing this, and we're doing things different because how long does it take us to upload a show? When we finish editing the show, how much time?
We have a half-hour show. It takes about 23 hours to upload.
Yeah, so it takes a full day for us to show. That's why we apologize for Bible study being late the other night. If we don't film on Monday night, we can't get the Bible study up on Wednesday. And if we don't film on Thursday night, it's hard to get the program up. So we didn't do different segments. I'm just going to sing a song right now.
Oh, would you? Well, this will be fun because I get to...
Yeah, we'll just do it, you know, how here. But I'll tell you what happened. We, last Bible study, we've been having great Bible studies on Wednesday.
Yes,
I shouldn't say
have.
That. Sounds a little bit arrogant on my part, but...
They have been having awesome Bible studies.
Thank you. You can promote it, but I don't want to sound like I'm boasting. But before Bible starts, at 6 o'clock, we serve a meal at our Bible study. Everybody gets a free dinner. And then they ate pretty quickly. So at 6:15, I started doing these TV theme songs that I wrote a long time ago and stuff. And I thought I would do it. If any of you out there are my age or around my age or Cheryl's age or whatever.
Or just round.
You remember programs like The Addams Family. Well, I want to open the show and sing a little song. I'm not going to change the set or anything. I'm just going to sing it right here. I've never done it this way, so we'll see if it all works out and stuff. But here's the title of the song. The title of the song is this, and you remember it as The Addams Family. We call it A Christian Family.
Mm-hmm.
Live, take it away. Start the music here, and hopefully it all going to work. Ready? Here we go. It's coming. Here it is. There's the music. It's coming. There it is. Remember this? Now, if you've never watched this show before, you think it's pretty strange, but that's okay. We're strange. We go. We're Christians and we know it. We're not afraid to show it. There's grace in case we blow it. We're a Christian family. We will be quite sincere. We're really glad you're here. No reason to feel fear in our Christian family. Are you going to sing it with me this time? Do you remember the words?
I think so.
You're a good snap in there. Sing it with me. We're Christians and we know it. We're not afraid to show it. There's grace in case we blow it. We're a Christian family. We will be quite sincere. We're really glad you're here. No reason to feel fear in our Christian family. Oh yeah, sorry. Switch the cameras, here we go. Crazy, 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 crazy. Do you remember that song?
That was fun.
You know, watching those black and white shows. I mean, that was considered horror.
Yes.
Horror. You know, and it was really scary for us for little kids, but I look back on it now, it was kind of really silly and fun.
Mundane
and
mundane compared to what they're doing now.
Well, you know, if you're first time watching, I know this is a little different show than we normally do, but thanks for being with us. If you're old viewers, we just want to say hi to everybody. And there's somebody, I always like to say hi to people that I know are watching the show, like Ruth and Jacqueline.
And Steve.
And Todd is a friend of mine that I just got an email from him that he's been watching the show. And
Ted and
Elise.
And Karen.
Steve. Did she say Steve all the way up in New England?
That was the first Steve. And then we have a Steve and Melissa here.
And we just want to say hi to everybody. Do we have anybody, family members out?
If we left you out,
my sister Judy, in case you're watching, we love you, and we're glad. We're really glad you're here. Well, here's what we're, if you've never watched the show before, good news is about hope for the future, healing for the past, because, you know, we all need hope for the future. You know, you face fear, what am I going through? But God is alive, He's on the throne, and the hope is, H-O-P-E, is hearing other people's experiences. And we like to give you experiences of how God takes care of all of us. And we talk about healing from the past because you'll never get ahead in life if you can't forgive people that have hurt you. We've all been hurt, but it's time, especially maybe even today, to get over it. But honestly, for today, I will tell you this. We say this all the time. We're real people with real problems, but we got real answers. And not that we're always in Christ, which is peace and joy. There's times that we get into craziness, when we're in a hurry, or the fear comes upon us, or guilt, or whatever. But for the most part, we like to live in the kingdom of God, which is righteousness, peace, and joy. But today, you know, you heard me just say that the opposite of Christianity is craziness. I believe that. We're going to talk about the whole salvation experience and how we change and stuff. Because here's our word for today. It's coming up on the screen.
Human nature.
Now read the definition, Cheryl.
The general psychological characteristics, feelings, and behavioral traits of mankind.
Of humankind. Yes.
Regarded as shared by all humans.
We got some great sayings here today. Let's take a look at these great sayings. In case you see us look down, it's because our TV monitor is right in front of us here. And here's some of the good sayings.
The most fatality in human nature is greedy and selfish. Wow.
Well, Albert Einstein, it's a little small on your computer screen there, but Cheryl will read it if you can read it here.
Human beings can attain a wealthy and harmonious life only if they are able to rid themselves within the limits of human nature of the striving for the wishful fulfillment of material kinds. The goal is to raise the spiritual values of society.
Wait, stop right there. We'll go to the cameras here for a second. Thank you, Liv. You know, what do you think that meant when you read that? What do you think that meant? That we want stuff.
Yeah, like stop trying to collect things and work more on your inside.
The greatest things in life aren't things. The greatest thing in life, believe it or not, are people.
Yes.
When you change your spirituality and you can love people and forgive people and give people grace, the greatest, that's funny, the greatest things in life aren't things. Mm-hmm. And that's what he was trying to say, if we be materialistic. You know, there's an interesting Bible verse. It says, the love of money is the root of all evil. People really misunderstand that verse. Because that verse basically is describing evil. What's behind all evil is somebody's trying to make a buck.
Agreed.
You know, and doing it in not an ethical or moral way. In fact, I believe it's Ecclesiastic, don't quote me, but 10:10. I think it's 10:10 or no, Ecclesiastics 4:4, you can look it up. The Bible says money solves all problems.
Yes, that is so true.
You know what I mean? And I don't know if I necessarily agree with that, but probably the problems we have here on earth, but I we're going to talk about human nature today and what we naturally do, and what we need to do is combine God, which is super, with the natural, and we have the supernatural. Take a look at another one of these sayings. You'll like this one. I love this.
Most people don't believe something can happen until it already has. That's not stupidity or weakness. It's just human nature.
There you go. Here's another one.
To feel much for others and little for ourselves is to restrain our selfishness and...
It's an eye test, honey.
It is.
And overcome. Is that what it says? I'm sorry, I read it and I can't see it on the TV. Is something our benevolent...
Let's say we're overcoming our benevolent
affections
constitute the perfection of human nature.
You know, basically what it's saying is get over yourself. That's not put it in a nutshell. I have no idea what that word was. I read it earlier, but I couldn't see it. Now, what's this one?
Love is the basic need of human nature, for without it, life is
disrupted
emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and physically.
And here's my favorite one of all.
The deepest principle in human nature is the craving to be appreciated. That, boy.
Isn't that true?
Yes.
I mean, I used to do a teacher appreciation program. I did that for years. And that's why, you know, it's neat that we don't have a million viewers, because we can recognize our little small audience here that we have and just say how much we appreciate you and those of you that are watching. And if we don't know your names, please email us and so that we can say hi to you. This show reminds me sometimes of Romper Room. Remember Romper Room?
We see.
Yeah, you remember she used to have this mirror and she'd say, romper, romper, bumper, boo, tell me, boo. And then her mirror, she'd come back and it'd be fuzzy and the mirror would come back and it would be gone.
Clear.
And she'd say your name.
Oh, didn't she just live in front of the TV for that moment?
It's like, oh my, she said my name.
Yeah, with me it was the Mickey Mouse Club because there was a Cheryl and I used to hide behind the wall and whenever they would say Cheryl, because they would jump out, I would jump out into the living room too. So.
But we have such a need to be appreciated. That's why we have these new cards that are coming. Should be in the here any day, little business cards, and we'll send them out to those of you who want. But it's to promote our show. And on one side, it says, watch online our Wednesday and our Sunday show. But on the back, it says, thanks for what you do. Your work is really appreciated. And I want to give them to people so that when you go to a restaurant, you can just flip it on the table with your tip or whoever does. You know, it's 7-Eleven.
And please do tip and don't just leave a card.
Yes, please. Don't make us look bad here and stuff. But, because people do, need to be appreciated. That's why we appreciate you guys so much. All of you that have kept us alive over this year, that have been obedient to God and,
indeed.
with your tithes, Bible says bring your tithes into the storehouse. And if you're getting fed here, then we thank you for bringing your tithes here. And for those of you that are being blessed by our program, you give us offerings and stuff like that. And, it's enabled us to keep this equipment and to keep doing what we're doing. So we're very grateful.
Yes,
and
indeed. Speaking
about appreciation.
Is it time?
It's time for that little girl.
Yes.
To introduce that little girl.
Yes, it is. Our daughter, Olivia, is going to join us in a little minute. And she's going to do the good movie for this week. So, Liv.
Thanks, Mom. Now for this week's good movie. This week's good movie is one of my dad's favorite movies, so here it is. This week's good movie is Accepted. It's about overcoming the fear of rejection, putting unusual gifts and talents to good use, and learning styles should fit the person, not the other way around. Awesome movie, learned a lot from it, watched with my dad a few nights ago. We had a father daughter time, it was fun. But yeah, watch the movie. It's amazing, as I always say. Now, here's my mom and my dad.
Yeah, I so enjoyed watching.
That's one of your favorite movies.
Yeah, it is. I so enjoyed watching it. Those of you, you have a chance to watch the movie. It's like that movie means so much to me because of the fact that, these kids are so rejected. And
you can relate.
I can relate, you know what I mean? Not chosen for the basketball team type of attitude we have in life. And especially in Christianity, I've never spoken in a lot of churches. It's not like I'm highly in demand, and that's probably one of the reasons I wanted to serve Jesus Christ and started my own church.
That's right.
And, it was a struggle, but if you watch that movie, she told you a little bit about the message, but the message is really simple. A bunch of kids that didn't get accepted at any college. And so what they do is they create a website and create a fake college. And, they get accepted at this college because it's their own college. And then the parents want to visit them, so they have to rent a building.
Oh my gosh.
It's just hilarious. But it's the speech that he gives at the end. I mean, some of it you may, think it's a little bit off color and stuff. And some of it you may think it's crazy. But the speech he gives has so much to do with so many of you out there that I know you're very much like me. You've gone through a lot of rejection. Mm-hmm. Some of you have gone through divorces, and it hurts.
Yes.
And basically, it's an attitude of self-righteousness that people have. I got it and you don't, which is not true. I mean, Jesus said we've all sinned and come short of, Paul, I believe, said we've all sinned and come short. We've come short of the love of God. The glory of God. Well, you can tell we don't edit the bloopers. We look at her. She's laughing like crazy. What was it we were laughing so much? Oh, we were coming home tonight. Liv is in the other room and she's going to start laughing. Shaw and I are on this new diet. It's we did this many years ago and it's called HCG. And I have lost...
HCG.
What did I say?
H.
H. Now you can hear my daughter in the other room laughing. HCG, okay. HCG. Well, I have lost. How many pounds have you lost? She's lost 15. I've lost. Keep the cameras rolling.
Maybe we just want to go to the next subject.
No. We'll just continue. No, we're just going to continue rolling this. I want you to see. Normally, we edit this stuff out when we lose it, but today we're just going for it because we can't stop the cameras. We got to get this out. But anyway, here's what happened. I got to the front door, and I've lost 15 pounds on this diet. It's been incredible. And I got to the door, and I wasn't wearing a belt. And my hands were full. And I said, yeah. I said to Liv, I said, yeah, my pants are, like, falling off. And I turned around and showed her, like, you know how kids wear their pants, like, kind of hanging down.
Sagging.
I said, look, I look like one of you kids. And when I turned back around, my pants fell totally off. So I'm standing there with in my boxer
at
short.
At the front door.
And Liv is
in
like
the parking lot.
Screaming, laughing so hard. And I'm thinking, can you pull my pants up? But she can't because she's on the floor laughing. But anyway, that's human nature.
You're a mess.
So, you know, we all get rejected. Why? Because of our human nature. And the attitude sometimes in Christianity is an attitude of self-righteousness. I have it and you don't. And why did Gandhi say, I love your Jesus, but I'm not sure about you Christians?
Yes.
It was very powerful because take a look at this verse in Romans and see what the truth is that the Bible says about righteousness. What does it say, Cheryl?
As Cheryl? It is written, nothing is righteous, no, not one.
No one. None of us. One. And that's why what Christianity is to change your nature from being a human nature to being a godly nature. Because it's very normal to be angry. It's very normal to be judgmental. I mean, some of you say, oh, I don't get angry. You probably don't get angry this way, but you get angry on the inside, which is depression. Others just blurt out. And what we're trying to do in life is to overcome this human nature, this fallen nature that's come upon us since the fall of Adam and Eve. But it is. I mean, Jesus is a heart surgeon.
Ooh.
He changes your heart. It's Dr. Jesus. And, you know, because, you know, the world says, follow your heart. Really? Well, you know, aren't people that are killing people just following their heart?
Well, it also says the heart is deceitful. If you're following that, you're being deceived.
Well, you know, the things that before you're saved, look what comes out of your heart. Take a look at this Bible verse in Matthew and see what it says.
For out of the heart comes evil thoughts, murder, adultery, sexual immorality, theft, false witness, slander.
Whoa. You know, I was reading something this morning. I'm reading Purpose-Driven Life again, and I think I'm going to be going into that a little bit. And I was listening to people. You know, Rick was talking, and I think that some Christians, you know, see the life that we used to live as being so bad, and they've got to turn everybody away from that bad life. But I think one thing they don't understand, that those of us who've lived the bad life, is that bad is not that good.
Mm-hmm.
If you've never lived the bad life, you know, I mean, doing drugs is not that good.
No.
Cheating is not that good. Do you feel guilty, you're afraid of disease? You live a world of fear, guilt, and you get angry. And so, you know, when you're in it, you think it's good because you're satisfying your human nature.
That's the selfishness.
But after a while, you're like, I'm living the good life. I like this so much better. I like this. I like being non-judgmental. I like loving people.
Peaceful,
joyful,
nice.
And this is why there's a, I wish I could say that I was born again and that everything changed immediately. And probably you wish, you know, you hear these people who have these experiences like the Apostle Paul, and that wasn't for me. I mean, for me, it's been a long, slow battle. I mean, one of my father's greatest challenges was, you know, his anger. And it's taken me years to get that under control. And now I'm really working on my weight because that's been the part with my mom. But take a look at the slide. I think we're all fighting this. It's kind of like we all have this Dr. Jekyll and this Mr. Hyde. You know, the Dr. Jekyll is the one that is respectable. Mm-hmm. You know, and the Mr. Hyde is the one that, oh, I can't believe I just lost it. And I can't believe I'm acting that way. You know, but take a look at this quote from Billy Graham. Cheryl, by the way, we'll be sending out the Billy Graham books here. This is what you're going to do it tomorrow morning. Those of you who've supported the ministry, you're going to get a copy of that. But here's a quote right from the book. What does it say here?
We have two natures within us, both struggling for mastery. Which one will dominate us? It depends on which one we feed.
Wow, thank you, Liv. Isn't that good?
That is
good. That's why.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what you have to do is if you're fear-based, you have to feed your faith and starve your fears.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, if you're listening to people and all things are bad and everything, you're feeding your fears. And okay, you know, I believe that, you know, that we're in end times. I believe that there's some things going on, but we need to prepare for end times out of wisdom, not out of fear, because the Bible says God hasn't given us a spirit of fear. In fact, fear will paralyze you.
Yes, and you won't hear from God what to prepare with.
Yes, exactly. Take a look at this other quote from Billy Graham.
We are to feed the new nature on the Word of God constantly, and we are to starve the old nature, which craves the world and the flesh. We are told to make not provision for the flesh.
That's why it's really challenging. I mean, you know, when you think about the flesh, you may be just sitting there thinking that he's talking about our sexual nature, but no, the mouth is the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
You know, probably that's why I'm doing this series called Sermon on the Mouth. The mouth is a real hard thing to control. It's not just, you know, going out and wanting to have sex with everybody. That's not just that. It's just the worldly thinking. I mean, the world feeds the flesh. Let's face it. I mean, you know, everything you see on TV, you know, what do you do when somebody attacks you? Attack them back. It's all about killing. We live in a violent world. And I mean, I just, you know, so it's like, okay, now we've got this new ISIS crisis. And, you know, and what's everybody going to do? We're going to shoot them. Look, Jesus said, you live by the sword, you're going to die by the sword. You know, if maybe God's called some of you to arm yourself up with 60 rifles and do all of that stuff, that's totally up to you. But, you know, I remember one time, this is when I decided to really start to change my life. This kid came up to me and pulled a knife out on me. And I had just gotten a knife. I was in the eighth grade. I pulled a knife out. That kid looked at me, started to laugh. He took his knife and flipped it through his fingers. Like, he goes, I know how to use it. I put my knife in my pocket and I ran. You know, so as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. And I'm going to believe in something that's much more powerful. And it's the power of love.
Divine protection.
Divine protection and the power of love. Mm-hmm. But, you know, that's between you and what God is telling you to do. But, you know, our human nature is survival. I mean, look, you read Fox's Book of Martyrs. You know, these people were willing to die for their faith, to die for what they believe in. And it's hard because Jesus is telling us to love our enemies.
Mm-hmm.
That's your human nature, is to hate and to kill. And, you know, but it's not where I want to go. Take a look at this other Billy Graham quote.
The greatest need in the world is the transformation of human nature. We need a new heart that will not lust and greed and hate in it. We need a heart filled with love and peace and joy. And that is why Jesus came into the world.
I remember, you know, I don't know if Ted's watching, but I'll never forget this conversation I had with Ted. And Ted said when he first came to church, they had hung Saddam Hussein.
Mm.
And I said that, you know, I mean, I wasn't dancing in the streets because I still believe that he was born as a child of God who somewhere along the line being in you know, getting different set of beliefs and whatever went into his life, just went down the wrong path. I mean, I don't want to minimize what he's done, because what he did was atrocious to people. But I think that, you know, heaven rejoices when one soul is saved, but heaven is also sad when a soul
is lost.
Mm. I mean, and what happens is that people are following that human nature. Take a look at this thing from Jeremiah, the scripture from Jeremiah 17:9. Look what it has to say.
The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately sick. Who can understand it? Wow.
It's hard. I mean, you know, why do we do what we do? Sometimes we're not really sure why we do, but we know what we do. I mean, remember in Miami, we had this man that ate another person's face. And I mean, we're having these beheadings. And, you know, why do people do? They're acting upon their human nature. Our human nature is a fallen nature. We want to kill. We don't want to forgive. We don't want to love. That's our godly nature.
Mm.
You know, but take a look at this other verse. I love Billy Graham's stuff. It's so good.
Men cannot help that it is their nature to respond to the lewd, to the, what is that one?
Salacious.
And the vile.
Yes.
They have difficulty doing otherwise until they are born again.
Yeah, when you're born again, you begin this process of you know, looking at, you know, the world is kind of backwards. You think that good is bad and bad is good. And when you become a Christian, you're like, man, I'm good is good. I want to live the good life. And I used to think that I lived the good life. But, you know, take a look at this other one. I love this one.
One of the ironies of human nature is that it often has a way of rejecting the best and accepting the worst. Oh, wow. Goodness.
That's why I love Dr. Phil. I watch his show every so often. He'll say, you can't fix something that you don't acknowledge. Mm-hmm. You know, we live, the dying process is, you know, I've heard this, you heard me say this before, is denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. Well, that means we live in a state of denial with some of our dysfunctions, you know. Mm-hmm. When people tell us we're dysfunctional, we get all angry, but they're just telling us their reality. Take a look at this about human nature, what Billy Graham has to say.
Acknowledge that there is a defect in human nature, a built-in waywardness that comes from man's rebellion against God.
Yeah, We just rebel against God. We rebel against good. We rebel, you know, why? We don't even know why. I mean, it's, you know, that's, you know, Liv is going, you know, she's a teenager, and of course we all know that teenagers rebel against cleaning rooms, and she's probably laughing right now. But it's good to have a clean room, but it's like, don't tell me what to do. I want to make my room messy. We rebel against what's good for us. You know, slow down. No, I want to run. You know, and we hurt ourselves. And all of a sudden we get older and God changes our heart and we change the way that we do things. We want to end the show today with this incredibly powerful verse from the Apostle Paul. Understand this. You know, a lot of people say, well, you know, just can't let people get away from this and, you know, and get away with all this and give them grace. No, no. Grace precedes truth. The law, the rules came through Moses, but grace and truth came to Jesus Christ. You know, it's like salt and pepper. You can't have one without the other. Grace and truth. Grace is you know, Jesus said, I am the way. The way is grace. He said, I am the life. I am the truth, okay? You got to have those two. Truth is reality, how life really works. And life is not about going for it. Our human nature is fearful. Our human nature feels guilty. Our human nature is prideful. Our human nature is angry. But take a look at these verses. We're going to put a bunch of slides up on the screen and Cheryl's going to read because I love this verse. Here's why we need grace in our lives. What does it say here? We'll go through all of them. Thank you, Liv.
I don't understand myself at all, for I really want to do what is right, but I don't do it. Instead, I do the very thing I hate. I know perfectly well that what I'm doing is wrong, and my bad conscience shows that I agree that the law is good, but I can't help myself because it is sin inside me that makes me do these evil things. It seems to be a fact of life that when I want to do what is right, I inevitably do what is wrong. I love God's law with all my heart, but there is another law at work within me that is at war with my mind. This law wins the fight and makes me a slave to sin that is still within me. Oh, what a miserable person I am. I know I am rotten through and through, so far as my old sinful nature is concerned. No matter which way I turn, I can't make myself do right. I want to, but I can't. When I want to do good, I don't. And when I try not to do wrong, I do it anyway. But I am doing what I don't want to do. I am not really the one doing it. The sin within me is doing it. Who will free me from this life that is dominated by sin? Thank God, the answer is in Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you, Liv. Thank you so much. You know, what he's doing is Paul is looking at truth. And at the end, he comes to grace.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the reality. Our human nature, we're messed up. We're just so screwed up. I mean, why do I do these things? Why do I not want to yell and people yell? And why do we, you know, I want to forgive, but yet I don't. And it's because of your human nature. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard to believe, but we spend all our lives almost like fighting these two, you know, these two people inside of us.
Yes.
Here's what I call it. Take a look at this slide. It's almost like each and every one of us, thank you, Liv, there it is. It's almost like each and every one of us has a Hitler and a Mother Teresa in us. You know, this Hitler who was, put that back up there, Liv, I want you to, this Hitler that just wants to do evil and this other one that wants to do good. When Jesus Christ comes in your life, we do all we can to push that Hitler away, and that Hitler just sort of dies in all of us. Sometimes he may creep up, but we push him down, and we do all we can to bring that Mother Teresa up, which is one of the people that were closest to Jesus. in our lives. Mm-hmm. Well, Liv, we thank you. I'm going to close this off with a song, but I just want to stay with you for a second here. Cheryl, next slide here is show everybody what our, you know, can you believe it? We're at 29. We're at half an hour. We got to leave here, but.
Okay, well, look, can I do my little offer real
you
quick?
You go to your offer. Here's this month's offer.
Yes, I do want to.
Go on Cheryl's camera here.
I do want to obviously make everyone aware. We have these dog tags, which I was looking at it, and it's not just like a dog tag. It says Jesus on it, and we can't do a close-up, but it has a scripture on the back. Obviously, no weapon formed against us shall prosper in Isaiah. And it also has a photograph, a very popular image of Jesus. So for any donation to the ministry this month, it's going to come in a nice little package like this, but you'll have your very own Jesus dog tag and something that will be near to your heart. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. So I do hope that you will keep this ministry in your thoughts and prayers, and as well as your continued financial support. Okay, Rick,
Thank you. No, I got one more thing. I just want to remind you that we got Bible study. I'm doing a series right now. It started last Wednesday called Sermon on the Mouth.
Ooh, yeah.
And if you didn't watch it, go back. It's life-changing for you. But I want to end, and
the time flew by.
Just absolutely flew.
But we're going to get a last song in, right?
Yes, we are. Liv, if you can turn the monitor up where you had it just very softly, we're going to do, turn it down. Okay, and we're going to do this song here as we close the show. Liv, you can start it. It's called, that poor girl's over there flipping slides and turning on monitors.
And making
we're
changes.
A one-person crew. God love you, Liv. It's called The Jesus That's in Me. It goes like this. Here it comes. You'll recognize the song. This is like my theme song. You heard me talk about the two people that we have in us? Kind of like the beauty and the beast, the Hitler, the Mother Teresa. But hear the words, I wrote this and changed the lyrics. It goes like this. I'll sing it to you. I was once so mad at the whole world. Then one day on my knees, I said, Jesus, please come into my life. Then my life was changed so instantly. Now I only hope that all people see the Jesus that's in me. I'll never be the same. Much to my surprise, it didn't take that long. I admitted I was wrong. Now I feel so right. You know, I just sense that somebody out there needs your life to be changed. Maybe you're not trusting God and you're afraid, or maybe you're feeling bad about something you did. Well, just take a moment and just say, Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I know I've made mistakes. And right now I'm asking you to come into my life and change my heart. Push out that Hitler and bring out a Mother Teresa in me. And you'll say, now I only hope that all people see the Jesus that's in me. And you know, if you gave your life to Jesus, send us an email, write to us, and say, now I only hope you see the Jesus that's in me. Thank you for joining us on Good News. We love you. God bless you. Bye-bye now. See you soon. See you Wednesday, okay? Okay.